This will make a fine space for my work, Eivor. Thank you.
Well, if your work benefits us, I will see that you keep it for as long as you live among us.
I believe it will, for we have eradicated them in London, then...
I will talk with...
Good.
A gift.
I cannot show...
I will. Lead on. I hear a heaviness to your breathing, Hytham. Does your wound still trouble you?
It does, I'm afraid. There is a pain in my chest for which I have no remedy.
Rest easy, then. So long as your mind stays sharp, you will recover.
Of course. Though I am reluctant to displease my mentor.
You risk your health and your life to please Basim. That I do not understand.
I should not expect you to. When we first arrived, I noted a shadow of suspicion in your eyes. A doubt. A wariness.
Is that a question?
No. Only an observation.
Are you well enough to steer this boat?
I am. Have no worry. It is only prolonged stresses that exhaust me. My energy runs low rather quickly.
And what is this gift you wish to give me?
It will not come from me. It is a gift you must give yourself.
Oh, riddles. What fun you are.
Let me say it another way. My gift is not for giving or taking. It is a way of living.
Still no clearer.
It is a thing better demonstrated than described.
Then I will wait.
Forgive my jest. This gift we call a leap of faith. It is one of our Brotherhood's most sacred rites. It is not a tool we use against our enemies, but an act we embrace to strengthen our resolve. Like your meditation, it centers our minds. Steadies our hands, and purges fear from our hearts. And more practically, it aids our movements, in flight or in stealth.
You call it a leap, and we're climbing a rather steep hill.
There it is again. The shadow of a doubt. Nearly there. Our destination is there.
I suspect you mean to throw me off this cliff. Is that it? Please tell me if I'm near the mark.
And spoil the surprise? To perform the leap of faith, you must give yourself over to something greater.
The gods?
Yourself. Embrace the hope that death will not come before you are prepared to meet it. Believe this, and you will fear nothing.
Our deaths are prefigured, weaved into the fabric of the world. To fear this would be a waste of worry and tears.
Good. Then your mind is already attuned to my lesson. I will leap first. On my word, you must follow. Lean into your faith, into your strength, and take flight.
You want me to jump from here?
Yes.
I would sooner grow wings and fly away. Thank you for the lesson, but...
Wait! And watch!
Hytham! Hytham! Pig-headed fool! Are you injured?
You see? My faith grew stronger than my fear!
And that loam cushioned your fall!
Eivor! I have not seen this side of you before! Do not feed your fear! Conquer it!
I've seen my death in a vision. It was not here. Not today. Ha!
A perfect fall! And how did it feel?
You spoke true. It was madness and vigor, a perching of fear. A gift I give myself. I see that now. Thank you for showing me the way.
Of course. And thank you, Eivor, for hearing me out.
You called this leap of faith a sacred rite. All Hidden Ones practice this same ritual.
As far as I know, it is a rite of initiation that dates back to just before the birth of the Christian Jesus.
Are you hoping to initiate me?
I might try if I believed you would join. But that is not my purpose in England. Basim and I are hunting larger prey.
The Order of Ancients.
Yes. You remember the medallion you took from Kjotve's body? That is their symbol. They are a plague, one we hope to purge from this world. Like us, they act in secret. But their aim is to rule the world, not free it from unnatural fetters.
The desire to rule is not unique to this order. Sigurd and I want the same. A land to call our own, and the honor that comes with it.
Do not compare yourself to such people. The Order has no honor, no principles, no humanity. Yet they sit on a great many of England's thrones. If you seek to pacify England for the safety of your clan...
Then it may be in my interest to give you aid. I understand.
You desire alliances. We seek to rid England of its deepening rot. Where these hopes meet, our cause does too. You may think this land ruled by harmless jarls and bumbling thanes, yet look more closely, and you will find a deeper threat. The Order's invisible hand touches all. It shapes everything, instilling its poison into every level of society. From the lowliest fishmonger to the richest merchants, from wealthy thanes to useless kings, the Order has corrupted all. Basim has given me one task here. To locate and eliminate the Order of Ancients in England, in whatever dark corners they reside. If we work together towards this end, it will benefit us both. You will have greater influence over the kingdoms of England.
And you will have more medallions to count.
Exactly. You should begin in London. I have credible reports that the Order is working now to seize the city.
I will speak with Ranvi about this.
And while you are there, be on the lookout for our symbol. Centuries ago, the Hidden Ones had bureaus built around England. There were six, I believe. If you can find them, search them well for documents bearing the same symbol. It will greatly aid my studies.
I will. Thank you, Hytham, for all of this.
Me out. I bow to this, but you will not unearth us all. You will not dig deeply enough. We are both a clot, and...
Are you well?
Why would you ask such a question at such a time as this?
Beneath your words is something of a size unknown. Repton. Sigurd should be here with the Regnasons.
Stay still. Who stands before Ivar Ragnarsson? Are you Sigurd Drenger? Igor!
Eivor. If you keep that up, we'll stain the floors.
The place could use some color.
Who are they?
All spies. Dressed to look the part of a peasant. Got feisty. Pitchfork. From this rabid little one. Was a time when you met and slew your enemy on the field before they could dream of things like sending spies!
And now we shake hands and make deals.
Not my thing.
I figured.
I love them whipped, weeping, and reeking of piss. Hey! Good boy. You're free, Saxon piggy, to run amok through the Mercian fields.
I would have let him down easy.
Follow me. I'll give you the tour.
What do you call this place?
I call it the Shithole. To the Mercians, it is Repton. Their most revered kings are buried below the church. Imagine their weeping when we drove them out.
You plunged your knife deep into the heart of this kingdom.
That is right. We've got a number of Saxon nobles lined up with their lips puckered, ready to kiss our asses. The only holdout is King Burgred and his warthane, Leofrith. But my brother is brewing a plan to deal with them.
I take it that's where we'll find my brother.
Right. Talkers they are, Uba and Sigurd. Might want to dig the wax from your ears.
Don't play me for a fool, Uba. I know Burgred. I'm not going anywhere, Bakrot. You have the king on his heels because of me. Because of my men.
For which you were paid. But that price does not change because you have caught a whiff of our Hacksilver hoard.
You forget I am a sellsword. I ask what I please, and I take what I'm owed.
If I wanted to hear you talk shit, I'd gouge out your tongue and shove it up your ass. Now fuck off.
Haggling over silver is a bad look for the son of Ragnar Lothbrok. But worry not, Uba. I have the warriors you need.
If this is one of them, my worries have vanished.
Eivor, Wolf-Kissed, you have come at just the right time. Uba and Ivar here are hunting a king.
And when we've caught him, we mean to crown another. Our dear Thane Shellwolf here.
It's not a role I begged for, but it's what Mercia needs just now.
I can't imagine the current king is too happy about all this.
Burgred is furious, of course.
The king has refused.
For now, Burgred is
another shithole.
We've held a siege there for weeks. If we take Tamworth...
Yes. Not every...
His request is...
Jaewolf betrayed his present king. Maybe tomorrow he betrays us too. Why trust him?
How can I answer that with any hope that you'd believe me? I only... And I want...
This is a good pl...
Agreed.
See this man...
The bowls...
I need to...
We have a four...
Lead the...
Take in the...
I'm glad...
Ease yourself.
For all...
A lively town. Quite a lot to see here.
Sail southeast. Bring the men to the gates of Tamworth.
Eivor, is your axe sharpened?
I'm ready for the spear din.
And the thunder of shields, yes. It's good to have you with us.
To fight beside such legends is an honor. I've only heard tales of your conquests. Now I get to live them.
We'll weave our sagas together. Thread upon thread.
Come on, boy. We'll forge a man from your softness, hammered on the anvil of
one
war.
One does not need to fight to be
Move!
A...
Move!
Calm, Eivor. The fight's not here.
Aye. The fight is nowhere to be found in this boy.
A boy who happens to be Ceolwulf's son. Why is he not in his quarters?
Our future king wants a battle-hardened heir. Time he proves his worth, don't you think?
Not yet crowned king, and already...
Right.
Eivor!
He comes with us. And should anything happen...
He'll want to remove...
Ha ha!
Mount up, Eivor. It's a long ride to Tamworth.
You'll have to endure my brother. He always finds new ways to humor himself.
I'll keep that in mind.
And both eyes open.
You smell that, Ceolbert? The stink of jealousy, of our budding friendship, I think.
What is Ceolwulf's son doing in Repton at all?
It's Ceolwulf's way of proving his loyalty. And there's no safer place for a traitor and his son than the middle of a pack of Danes.
Safe from who? You and Eivor seem to have brought this Shire to hell.
Fears are with us. Common folk. But Burgred still has his soldiers all over Mercia. They're devoted to him. And they'll die defending him.
Your voice, Eivor. You sound different than the brothers.
Good ear, Lord. Most in England cannot tell the difference. But not all Danes are Danes.
From where do you come, if I may ask?
North of the Danelands. A place called Funbeck, Norway.
I didn't know there was land north of there. What are the people like?
You ever see a herd of sheep follow each other off the edge of a cliff? They're like that. The ones who remained, anyway.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Was this a mass exodus from Norway, then?
It was. Norway is now the province of a young king, Harald by name. A boy wise beyond his years.
Are you not angry that he has displaced you and so many others?
I was, for a time. But our weeks at sea have softened my brow fire. If I am honest, I realize I quite admire King Harald. By words and by weapons, both. He has pacified the country I call home. For the first time in any man's memory, or any skald's song, Norway has one king. Just one. And that is quite a feat.
That is impressive, truly. England is half the size of Norway, and yet we have four kings for our four kingdoms.
You see? How could I not be impressed? No, Harald is a good man with grand ideas. I can see that now.
I am only 6 years his junior, and have yet to see my first battle. I cannot imagine the skill and cunning he has.
Your first battle is coming, young Ceolbert. From this day on, you may see rapid progress.
I'm not sure I want so swift a rise.
In truth, Ceolbert, it is my father who bears the heaviest weight of my anger, not King Harald. My father gifted my birthright to Harald without my consent or knowledge. As easily as if he might hand over a barrel of mead. It was not merely a deception. It was a betrayal of trust. The prick of which still stings me.
Be it a blessing or a curse, family is always first.
A good line, boy. Were you not an atheling, I would hire you as my skald.
Skald? It sounds something like Scott, our court poets. Is that what you mean?
Right again.
Fascinating. The harmony between our words and yours is quite something. As if we were distant cousins, separated by an ocean of time as well as space.
I like the thought of that. I do.
Gods,
at these pagan rats. Ravenous, unseemly beasts teeming over holy ground.
Have a care, Lord. These pagan rats outnumber us.
I can see that, fool. What do we do about them?
I advise we strongly consider their demands, Lord. We won't survive a fight.
Is that you, Leofrith? How quickly you recover! I'm beginning to wonder if it is a man or a god beneath all that armor.
A man of God stands before you!
That's Burgred's war thing.
That...
Enough!
We've come...
With...
I admire...
Would you settle for a Norse? We're not as gentle, but we're much better poets.
Norse, Dane, dog.
My king.
I grow weird, and yet it no more! If you want...
Back to the... Eivor, tell the captain we're ready to march. Eivor and I will round up the men. Do you know your way around a battering ram?
I've seen them in action.
I want you at the helm of ours.
I'll be there.
As will I.
Rest from rattling skulls.
Who are you? I'm with the Regnason. Let's go.
Where are we going?
Jailed.
I know these men, eh?
Friends.
It cannot be.
When the march begins.
Do not think.
There's no other.
Leave the king to me.
By the hood, stranger.
Forward! Push forward! Release!
My side, idiot. Hold up a fight.
Pay for your sins.
Please!
It's over, Burgred! Lay down your weapons and surrender!
Take three men and search the rear. Look around. See what you can find. I'll send for Ceolwulf. Tell him we found a throne.
Ah, that was a good scuffle, hmm? But I did notice we were short one Atheling. Where was the son of our king?
A chronicle of payments made. Like a ledger. There's a symbol here. A clan name.
Ivar, I found a letter. There's a symbol here. Your men have any luck?
Nothing. You?
This. Do you know that symbol?
Tana's sigil. It seems she's been dealing with Burgred as well.
She was the mercenary Bark.
She could have told him.
Why bother with all this pageantry? Fashion a new crown and stick it on your melon. There you have it. You're the new king.
That is not how...
We have...
It won't...
Tona...
I would sue...
I might...
We have the...
Meet us at...
And your axe!
Eivor!
Go. I'll...
I will...
My son...
You would be...
No.
He'll come around...
Not going to end well.
Just keep your wits up.
Sigurd, is there...
We'll go see Tumna. Just it, the truth is...
Right.
We'll return shortly.
A small fortune for whoever sent Tona to hell.
I'll hold you to that. From what I overheard in Repton, the brothers had an arrangement with Tona. What happened?
She's a mercenary. Ubay used her for man and information. But that relationship soured now that Burgred is all but defeated. From what I heard... Tana has hunger for two things. Soft silver, and a stern hunt. Neither of which earns you true loyalty.
If she can't be trusted, what use is she?
That is for us to find out. We may be able to satisfy her.
And if we can't?
Ivar did tell you to bring your axe.
And here they are, as expected.
If she takes a liking to you, keep...
Sigurd. What brings you strolling into my camp this brisk day?
I suspect you already know.
Yes. The Emperor's on the air betray you. And yet, if you are here talking to me, King Burgred remains at large. And who are you, lovely dove? Want to perch your ass on my lap?
That's not why I'm here.
Where is King Burgred? That is what you...
We found letters. Records of trade.
What can I say? The king pays well for my services. If only I could say the same for those two Ragnarsson clods.
You're dealing with me now. And I want to know what you know. Name your price.
Very well. I could use another cow. And you can cover the cost.
Here's your silver.
Right, Bessup.
Out with it.
Burgred paid me to steer the Ragnarssons clear of two areas. Ledechester, if I were you, that's where I'd look. And that is all I know, not more.
Ledestre and Temp-
I don't, but the brothers will.
Go away. Sigurd's told us the news. Well done.
Let Burkrit.
And what do we...
Let me...
We should...
I will join
that leave
enough.
Go on ahead.